In this video, we are going to discuss about Python program to print reverse of a given number. Let the number is 786. So the reverse of 786 is 687. We have to display 687 as the output. Let the number is 123. So reverse of 123 is 321. So now let's see the program. In order to read data from the keyboard in Python, we use input function. But the problem with input function is input function returns the data as a string. So we have to convert that string into integer. So that should be done with the help of int function. So n is equal to int of input of enter a number. So now that number will be stored in a variable called n. The next statement is rev is equal to 0. In order to perform reverse of a number, we have taken a variable called rev whose initial value is 0. Now let us see the logic. While n is greater than 0, here this is the logic here. Totally we have three statements are there. So first we have to calculate the remainder. So r is equal to n modulo 10. Next, this is the formula. This is the formula for calculating reverse of a given number. Reverse is equal to reverse into 10 plus r. Next, in order to get the remaining digits of the number, this we have taken this statement. N is equal to n by 10. So this is called as integer division or floor division. This double slash, if we use double slash, then we will get integer division or floor division. Whereas if we use only single slash, then we will get floating point number. But here we need that integer coefficient, integer quotient. So that's why we have taken this slash slash. So whenever the condition is false, then the reverse number is available in rev variable. So we have displayed rev. Now let us see problematically whether this logic is correct or not. After that, we will execute this program in a computer. Let's see the program here. Let the number is 786. 786 is greater than 0. Condition is 2. So the body will get executed. So first we have to calculate the remainder. So 10 786, 10 78s are 780. 786 minus 780 means 0. So modulo will always give remainder. So what is the remainder value? Remainder value is 6. So r is 6 now. Okay. Next, rev is equal to rev into 10 plus r. This is the formula here. Okay. In order to calculate reverse of a given number. So rev is equal to rev into 10 plus r. So what is the initial value of rev? 0. So 0 into 10 means 0. 0 plus what is the remainder we got? 6. So 0 plus 6 means 6. So after the first iteration, we got reverse of last digit as the output. Okay. So what is the reverse of last digit? 6 reverse means 6 only. So we got 6 as the output. Okay. Next, n is equal to n by 10. So what is n value? 786. What is 786 by 10 means actually we will get 78.6 as the result. But this is what integer division or floor division. So integer division means we will get only 78 as the result. Why? Because here floor function will be applied. So floor means we will get an integer value which is less than 78.6. So what is the value which is less than 78.6? 78. So we will get the 78 as the result. So in the next iteration, n value will become 78. So once again, the control will go to the while loop. 78 is greater than 0. Condition is true. So the body will get executed. R is equal to n modulo 10. So 10 sevens are 70. 78 minus 70 means 8. Now remainder value is 8. So 8 will be stored in R. Next, rev is equal to rev into 10 plus R. What is the previous value of rev? 6. 6 into 10 means 60. Plus what is the remainder value we got? 8. So 60 plus 8 means 68. After the second iteration, we got the last two digits reverse. So if we reverse 86, then what is the output? 68. So 68 is the output. So after the second iteration, we got reverse of last two digits. Okay. So next, n is equal to n by 10. What is n value? 78. 78 by 10 means actually 7.8 is the result. But here with division means floor will be applied. If you perform floor on 7.8, then we will get that integer value as the result, integer quotient. So what is the integer quotient? 7. So we will get 7 as the result. Now n value is 7. So once again, control goes to the while loop. n value is 7, 7 is greater than 0, condition is true, so body will get executed. So 10, 7, 10 zeros are 0, 7 minus 0 means 7. So r is equal to n modulo 10. So here the remainder is 7. Next reverse is equal to reverse into 10 plus r. So what is the previous value of rev? 68. So 68 into 10 means 680 plus we got remainder as 7. So 680 plus 7 means 687. So now rev value is 687. Now 7 by 10 means we will get this 0 as the result. So once again control question of while loop. 0 greater than 0 means false. Condition is false. So the control comes out from the while loop. So reverse of n is, what is the value of reverse, what is the value of rev? 687. We will get 687 as the output. So how many times this while loop will get repeated? That depends upon number of digits of that number. Okay, here in 786 we have 3 digits are there. So that's why here we have repeated for how many times? The while loop is repeated for 3 times. Okay, whereas if the number contains 4 digits, then the while loop will be repeated for 4 times. In the first iteration we will get the reverse of the last number as the output, that is 4. In the second iteration we will get the reverse of last 2 digits as the output, that is in the second iteration we will get 43 as the output. In the third iteration we will get reverse of last 3 digits as the output, the reverse of 234 is 432. In the last iteration we will get reverse of these 4 digits, so we will get 4321 as the output. So in this way we can calculate, we can print reverse of a given number. Now let's execute this program in a computer, whether this logic is correct or not. Now let us see the program execution. So first n is equal to int of input of enter a number. So n contains the number, the initial value of rev is 0, while n is greater than 0. So this is the logic. R is equal to n modulo 10, reverse is equal to reverse into 10 plus r, n is equal to n by 10. So this is floor division. So print reverse of the number is rev. So let us execute the program once. Let the number is 786. Reversed of given number is, what is the reverse of 786? 687. We got 687 as the output. Let us execute the program one more time. Let the number is 1234. So reverse of 1234 is 4321. So this is the output. So with this we can conclude that our program is